What is electromagnetic compatibility, or EMC? And why should we care about it? To answer the first question, let's ask Wikipedia. This text tells us something about electromagnetic interferences, about emissions, about susceptibility and immunity, and about coupling mechanisms. But hey, there are pictures as well. So let's take this guy here for example. He experiences EMC every day, even though he might not notice it. For example, driving a car has something to do with EMC. Or using a vending machine has something to do with EMC. Home office has to do with EMC as well. And playing video games has to do with EMC. But what do all these situations have in common? Dying during an exciting game because a work buddy calls is just annoying. Internet speed issues during an online meeting can be very nerve-wracking. An electrostatic discharge might be hurtful, but can cause a lucky situation as well. Not so fun, however, is when the car brake does not work. Oh, this can end badly. Another real-life story. Imagine you're on vacation, in Australia, enjoying the sun. You buy some groceries, get a near-rented car, and the doors lock. But the car will not start. The air conditioning remains off. The door's still locked. You realize you're trapped inside the car and the sun becomes your enemy. This might lead to a painful death. The name of your new foe? EMI, electromagnetic interference. Unfortunately, such EMC problems happen quite often, even if you don't notice them. Ironically, more cars are recalled today than newly registered. In order to prevent such dangerous situations in the future, international regulations exist. So we need to grade the electromagnetic compatibility of our devices in such a chamber. On the one hand, how many emissions our electronic devices produce, and on the other hand, how many emissions our devices can withstand. If we want to sell a product, we must not exceed certain interference limits according to international regulations. But did you know that an estimated 50% of products fail first-time EMC testing? Other experts even speak of a 70 to 90% failure rate if the topic of EMC is ignored during the product design phase. But testing costs are very high because they often take place in an accredited test house. You should therefore go for a get it right first time strategy. You cannot ignore the topic of EMC. An entire company could be ruined if it sells products while breaking the law. As a self-employed person, you may even face imprisonment. After all, people could die from poorly designed products. Now that we know what EMC is, we can ask ourselves how to get that nasty interference under control. Unfortunately, there is really no easy answer to this. But we, at Graz University of Technology, do our best to help you understand the many topics of EMC in a hopefully fun way. Because it's our goal to enhance your future product.